Hello, hello. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming. We'll have people trickle in, but today I would like to start a casual repotting of our plants. I am in Atlanta, which is south of in the southern part of USA, and basically we have just started with fall here. The temperatures are starting to go down. I have a lot of plants that spend their summer outside, so I am trying to bring some of them back indoors. While doing that, I have to do a lot of plant chores, like cleaning the leaves, cleaning everything before they come back indoors. So generally I spend my afternoons trying to do all the plant chores. So I thought, why not go live while doing the plant chores. The agenda today is I have three plants here. I have the Cebu Blue, that definitely needs a new pot. I have another rickrack cactus and a ponytail palm. We are going to repot them, clean them, and get them ready so that they can come indoors. And I'll probably not be doing a lot of talking, just showing, you know, how I'm doing stuff around here. And then if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. Any question is fair game. You can ask questions about plant care. You can ask questions about running a business, how we are growing, future plans, you know, whatever questions you have on your mind, feel free to ask those. While doing all these, I can respond to those. But other than that, we'll get started. I'll talk the first about this particular plant. You can see, I have used the monstella. So this one I got as a two-leaf cutting. It's a Cebu Blue. So it's called Cebu Blue because, you know, it has these like shimmery, in the right light, you can actually see like a bluish tinge to the leaves. And you know, it has grown quite a bit in the past, you know, 3 or 4 months. I potted it in this small pot, but you can see the roots are coming out. So my plan is to take this out of this this one and put it in this other, you know, bigger pot, so it's a size up. And then while also doing that, instead of having it trail, I am thinking I'm going to stake it, so add a support to it. And we can talk more about this, but basically you must have seen pictures of Cebu Blue on Instagram where people have staked it, and once they mature, some of these leaves can actually, you know, become much bigger and also develop some fenestrations, and they look pretty cool. So my plan is to try to do that, try to at least achieve that. I have this pot. I generally use like a small piece of, you know, paper, a thin paper to like cover the drainage hole, otherwise, you know, soil keeps on draining out. And then I've already prepared my soil mixture, so it's generally a mixture of potting soil as well as some perlite and bark, and all that is mixed in, and I've kept it prepared. I'm gonna try to first get the plant out of here. And the roots are not that long, but I don't know, it's a tiny plant, but still the roots were poking out from the bottom. I'm not going to use the old soil. I'm just going to take this one and move it to this other pot. I have like two different vines, so my plan is to actually use one stake and stake it on both sides. I'll be using Zella to stake it, so we can try that. It's a beautiful day here today. It's in the 70s, so 70 Fahrenheit. Fall is really gorgeous in this part of town. Although we don't see all the, you know, vivid colors, I used to live in the north, and there the colors can be, you know, spectacular. But here the colors, you know, are not as vibrant as in the north. But, you know, weather-wise, I think it's gorgeous around here too. Make enough space so that we can put one of them right here. Just going to add some more soil to make sure it's all in there. plan is to start using the Zella. This is the regular sized Zella, and it should be perfect for this one. It's going to outgrow the stake pretty quickly, but I have an extension too, so we might have to use the extension. And the plan is to, you know, try to get it to attach to the cedar. It does, you know, mature and fenestrate and do all the good things that we wanted to do. I have two options here. I can either just use like plant Velcro to hold it together, or I can use, you know, some rubber bands. But my plan is, because I want it to attach, the better way of doing that is if the vine is as close to the stake as possible, and it's hard to achieve that by just using plant Velcro. So I am going to use some hair ties, basically. So I have these clear hair ties that I can use. My plan is to just, in the front, this is how it looks. Technically, it can go on the other support. So for now, I'm not going to add the extension. I'm just going to add the end unit, end cap to it. Voila, this one is ready now. I think it looks really good. I'm going to do a musical chair. So this one is in a nursery, it still is in a nursery pot. And you can see it's like all lanky and long. This one was in full sun, so you can see some sunburn that has happened because of that. There are no roots coming out from the bottom, so I think I'm gonna pot it in a similar size pot. So this pot is probably the best size for it, so I'm just gonna use this one because I like the orange color. You can see the roots are pretty fine on here. I'm just going to put it in this pot and, you know, add more soil to it. You see, it's all very well put in now. There is this, you know, dead twine, so I'm gonna remove this. So this one is taking a lot of space. Like, you can see this thing is going all the way on the side. I am going to try to use a trellis to help you know, get around that problem. So I'm gonna use the cat trella. I have an old one that was lying around. And then maybe, you know, like get some of the twines to like go through some of these holes, so that at least, you know, they are not everywhere and it's more upright. So now you can see it's slightly more manageable. So now it's not going to take up around, you know, 12 feet of my space. It's still going everywhere, like trying to figure out what the best way of putting it on is, but let's see. I try to make my plants look, use them as home decor, and for that, you know, they need to look reasonably presentable. Definitely needs a good drink of water. You can see these leaves are starting to turn, and some of these leaves have a pinkish tinge to them, but yeah, I think this is ready to go indoors now. I don't see any bugs or anything. Generally what I do is, this came from the outside, so I will definitely spray it with some neem oil, just to be sure there are no hitchhikers on there. So I make this solution, but I just use some water with a little bit of dish soap and a few drops of neem oil, and just like give it a nice shake, and just use that to spray on, just to be sure, you know, there's nothing out there. It has a funky smell, that's why I'm doing it this outdoors. Indoors, it just the smell lingers everywhere. This is ready, so you have the rickrack cactus, we have the sibu blue, and then the last one. Hello, hi everyone that is joining now. I don't think I'm gonna use any trellis on it, but you know, this is my big ponytail farm. And this one stayed, has been outside in my front porch. It was in on a covered porch. It still got a lot of southern sun, so you can see inside here. I don't know why, but it doesn't have enough soil. It's like the soil, it is just sort of hanging out. I can almost see the roots on the top. And it's like toppling on the side, so I need to just give it more soil to sit inside. And then also maybe just remove all the dead leaves and also clean up the leaves. So I'm going to do that. It is definitely root bound, but these plants actually like to be root bound. So I'm not going to change the pot. This I don't have many of these, you know, bigger size pots anyway. So I'm going to let it be in this pot for at least this winters, and then we'll figure out what we need to do about it in the summer. But visible. Okay, so a bug came out. That's the problem with plants outside. You know, I saw something crawl up. Like, standing straighter now. How frequently should we change the soil? Depends. Generally, the general rule of thumb is at least once in 2 years. So I generally tend to repot my plants, or at least take them out and add some fresh soil once every 2 years. But it depends on, you know, I mean, sometimes you have to do it sooner if they have grown so quickly. I repotted this last year though. So I mean, I had moved it up from a smaller pot to a bigger pot, and I still think this size pot is fine for it. So one trick that I do for cleaning, so because it's coming from the outside now and it is going to go indoors, I want to be very sure. I mean, this is going to be a pain to clean, but I'm going to just show you the initial stuff of how I clean. Basically what I do is, instead of using a cloth, I use an old sock, and all I do is I'm going to just like spray it with this neem oil soap water mixture and just go at it. And then just like quickly, you know, go and wipe the leaves. This is easier for like plants which have, you know, huge leaves. So you can like clean them, you know, I mean, then you only have to clean like 10-15 leaves. This one, because it's like a longer sort of, thinner, longer leaves and lots of them, it takes a while. But you can see, you know, my sock is so dirty. So, I mean, it definitely needs a good cleaning, and it's probably going to take me a good, you know, 15-20 minutes to clean it. But this is my meditation session of, you know, just like touching the plant, being outside, and just like enjoying my time alone with it. But sometimes I just use a spray of water and dish soap, and that should be more than enough. Later on, I'll take a picture of where these plants go inside in the house. But yeah, so that's my ponytail palm. I think this is a good session, and we'll probably try to do one of these every 2 weeks or so. Maybe try to do it a more, you know, community repot. So you guys can also come in and show off your plants and repot with me. If you have any questions or last minute comments, feel free to ask, or else you know where we are. We are very accessible via direct messages. You can send us an email. We are always very responsive to those. And thank you for all the support you guys have given us in the past year now. I have one question. How should I take care of my rubber plant during winters with hardly any sunlight out there? Yeah, so for rubber plants or any plants that you bring indoors, one of the ways of when you bring them indoors, the problem is, you know, you don't have enough sunlight, and that can affect the plant. So one of the things that you should consider doing is adding grow lights indoors, and there are a ton of options out there. And we are working on a blog post. We'll probably post that with more information on how to use grow lights and where to use them. But there are a ton of options for grow lights, and you can basically add them in whichever space you want. You can even get timers that can go on the grow light, so it doesn't stay on all the time. You keep it on for like 8 hours, 12 hour cycle, whatever cycle you want for that plant. And depending on where you place the plant in association with the grow light, it can help in, it can basically give you, you can basically scale the lighting based on, you know, how far away you are from the light. So I would say grow lights are a very good option. Thank you everyone for joining this quick lunchtime repotting session. and we'll be back maybe in a couple of weeks. Make sure you keep on following us on social media. See you later. Bye.